So can you imagine you're leaving Stanford, you're getting on a plane, you're going back to San Diego, you're filming a music video, you're meeting your father for the first time, you're dealing with all sorts of internal emotional things, and you still have an album that needs to get done.
Sometimes I hate walking around with my shades on.
It makes me feel pretentious, but I'm confident in my...
Pretentiousness?
No, not pretentiousness. I'm confident that I mean well, and I am trying to pursue humility at all times. The sun is out, so my shades are on. It has nothing to do with...
your status?
None at all. I don't. Plaques? What status? What
your Grammys?
What are you talking about? I don't even...
You don't know what those are?
I count them all as loss.
All of them.
All as loss.
All of them.
Beats are hard because sometimes if it's amazing, it's going to move me. I'm going to feel it. It's going to speak to my soul. But sometimes it may be something in there that I didn't hear, and it just has to be written to, and then something comes out.
Spectrum, I keep a city 5 cities on the back phone. I be rapping too long. I go for 7 hours, dog. I gotta stop.
It's a book called A Body Keeps a Score.
Yeah.
That'll help you process it. Your body keeps a score, so like whatever happened to you in your past, your body's like, I ain't processed it. And especially if it happened as a kid, your brain ain't developed enough to know how to process it. So all the stuff that happened to me as a kid doesn't bother me because you process it at the level you are. So if I would have happened to me as an adult, it probably would have stressed me out. I fought somebody, killed somebody.
Yeah.
But as a kid, my brain is like, okay. That's what got me to the point on this whole album, is going through all this process and being like, I don't care about none of this. You know what I'm saying? Grammys, got them. Plaques, got them. But I'm doing all that to cope.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's why on the other song I said I was drinking liquor as an antidepressant.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I was like, I gotta chill.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, what we saying? Healing, helping. I'm on that vibe.
Yeah.
Right. I accept you. Who are you? I don't know. It's cool.
All in, everybody in.
I just pray that all the things that we concocted, that we put together, will go out into this world and really just change things and allow people to just experience the gifts that you've given us, and it allowed them their lives to be better because of it. We ask all this in your name. Amen.
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 The music is so good. What are we gonna do? I'm not fully aware of what God has done with everything that I'm doing, but I don't need the credit at this point in time to prove it.
I've been with you at your worst. You are the better you. You said, I'm not in control. You're healthy, bro.
Yeah.
The beautiful thing about restoration is it's never the end. No matter how ugly it is, it's never the end. There's always hope. And then on top of that hope, you don't have to go through it by yourself. There's so many other people who are going through this, and people of prominence, people who are respectable, people who you admire, that are battling intense things.
And things have fallen so far since being the NBA success story. But how do I today have more joy and more peace and more purpose than in that moment at the mountaintop? Again, it is all about what God is able to do through me.
You feel like you want to breathe, but you literally can't. And so that is like one of the most haunting feelings for me. I feel that often.
I think we understand the stresses and the grind of, you know, being on stage, you know, every single day, and that means something.
When my mind was so clouded, when I thought I was losing my mind, my priority shifted to making sure my health was intact. And then once my mental health was in a better space, now it's time to be present with my family like never before. the world can find another Lecrae, my kids won't get another dad.
I could always articulate how important it was for me to be present in the home, but I could talk it better than I could walk it, you know what I mean? But presence is not just your physical, you know, being there. Presence is like, you know, giving of yourself to your family. And that's changed dramatically for me. You know, I used to like carry my family along with me on the journey to do what I wanted to do. And I realized how unfair that was. You know, they don't want to be with me in the green room backstage. They want to be with me at a trampoline park. And if I'm not creating those opportunities, then, you know, I'm selfish. And that's been where everything has changed, is that I've put my life on halt to make sure I'm present for them and the things that they care about.
Watch out.
Here we go.
This is Daddy on his sleigh.
Over.
Don't you think I... And that was Daddy.
Here we come. Come on.
Restoration is a lifelong process, but you can enjoy the journey.
Yeah, they not ready. I hope the brake lights work. Yeah, you see it. I see that, Lexus. You see it. You see it.
Restoration is a beautiful thing. I mean, I think sometimes we make restoration into this like massive, transformative thing that you can't touch, and you know the world will be restored, and I think that's true and that's good, but sometimes you can find restoration in the smallest things, you know, in just a tangible metal object like a car, seeing something that was amazing get torn up and then go through a process where it comes out better than it was before is something beautiful to see. So for me, things like that are a reminder that that's a picture of my own life. That's a picture of your life, that restoration is possible.
That season of just depression and pain and turmoil, my wife, she's my hero in a lot of ways because she's very gracious. She showed me what patience looks like. She showed me what the patience of God looks like and how she just dealt with all of that pain and all of that turmoil.
My dad texts me every day now. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't even fathom that 2 years ago, 1 year ago, and now even in this process, restoration is occurring and existing. So I just say that to say, I've just seen it over and over again. And that's what I want people to understand. Marriage, relationships with people you love, your own life, your faith, your career, it is never over. As long as you have breath in your lungs, restoration is possible.
You know, one of the early conversations I had with Craig was, you know, I'm surprised that I'm a Christian, let alone a pastor, because of things that I've seen in the church myself. But I think all of those things have come to play together to kind of drive me to a place where I want to be as vulnerable as I can with as much wisdom as I can.
I want to say things that come from a real place for my own life, because I know I'm not alone in what I'm going through. I just got to battle the insecurities of whether or not people think I'm dope or whether or not people think I should be doing this, and I need to get to the purpose behind why I'm doing it and let that be enough for me.
For me, it's been really beautiful feeling restored and given that peace from being a servant leader. And so I have just been trusting God on this walk of being a servant leader, and he has brought so much peace and joy into my life.
Lecrae has this opportunity to say it's not as scary as it seems. It feels scarier because you don't have language for it, but it's not as scary. In his honesty and in his transparency, I feel like he will help Black people embrace vulnerability and transparency in a way that I feel like they don't always feel the freedom to. And it's powerful.
We're all on a journey of being restored. And that's the choice that we make. Do we want that process? Do we want to engage it? Or do we want to sit in, you know, in dysfunction? You know what I'm saying? Do we want to sit rusted? Or do we want to join in on this process of being restored and get to that place? You know, just like this vehicle, it's always going to need an oil change. It's always going to need gasoline. It's always going to need maintenance. But it's not in a junkyard sitting there collecting rust and doing nothing. It's in the process. And that's how I am. That's how we all should be, is in that process of being restored constantly.
As painful as the things that I've gone through, as painful as the things are that you've gone through, none of those things are beyond restoration.